so excited about this. When Renogy said they were coming out with a Bluetooth battery, I thought, I need this. I need this in my solar system. So I got one. It just arrived today, and we are going to unbox, review, and install this puppy. All right. Let's see what we got here. Directions, warranty stickers, more directions, mounting bolts. Ooh, caps. They didn't actually have this for the 100 amp hour one. These will be a nice little addition, just in case any moisture happens to get in there. Wow, this battery's bigger than I was expecting, actually. It is definitely bigger than my Canbat one. Get out of here. Oh, jeez. Oh, look at that. Wow, that is slick. Big fan, Renogy. Big fan of this design. This looks really good. So first impressions are this battery is quite a bit bigger than any battery I have owned. It's 200 amp hours, just like the Canbat one I have. This battery is quite a bit larger. I don't know if that's to do with the Bluetooth. I believe this is the largest battery that Renogy actually has come out with. Previously to this, they had the 170 amp hour battery and then the 100 amp hour battery. But I believe this is their first 200 amp hour lithium model. And I mean, it looks great. It has a nice hard protective shell. Right off the bat, hands down, favorite feature of this battery is the fact that it only costs $1,200 right now, Canadian, and $999 American. $1,000 gets you 200 amp hours plus a built-in Bluetooth function, which is amazing. I mean, Renogy is definitely one of the most affordable solar companies out there. And especially when it comes to lithium batteries, like this is really good, unless you want to go out and build your own lithium battery. I know a lot of people have been doing that. It's getting a lot more popular and it's getting a lot more easy to do. Like you can buy your lithium cells and then get your BMS and install that. You can save a lot of money that way. But if you want to go something that is already built, I am definitely going to be adding this into my solar guide. So if you haven't already checked out my solar guide, I will link it below in the description and up in the corner. Check it out if you're a beginner and want to learn more about solar systems. This guide is perfect for you. It comes with a schematic, a cost breakdown, and it also explains the role of each component in your solar system. So it is perfect for beginners. I have in my system already Renogy's BT2 monitor that I've hooked up to my phone, and it works pretty well. I usually have it connected to my DC to DC charger with MPPT so I can see how many amps are coming in through my alternator and the solar panels. But being able to hook up to the battery using Renogy's DC Home app will be really nice so I can see exactly how much power I have from anywhere. I don't have to open up this bench seat and look at the battery monitor to see what my percentage is at or anything like that. I'll just be able to pull my phone up and see exactly what's going on. This battery has a maximum charge current of 100 amps and a maximum discharge current of 200 amps. Its operating temps are from minus 20 degrees Celsius to plus 50 degrees Celsius. And of course, the BMS inside will automatically shut it down if it drops below 0 degrees Celsius to make sure it doesn't damage the battery. I love that Renogy put a Bluetooth feature in their battery, but I would also love if they would do their heating feature in the battery so you could get a 200 amp hour Bluetooth battery with its internal heating function. That would be perfect. I'm sure it'll come out soon enough. After I ordered this battery, I went through all the reviews online and read what you guys are saying about it and people who have already purchased and installed it in their system, and everyone seems to love it. The only negative comments are actually about Renogy's DC Home app, and after downloading it on the App Store, it has a 2 out of 5 star review. If Renogy is gonna put some work into something, I think it would definitely be their app. I haven't had a big issue with their apps. They seem to be okay, but it does appear that people are losing connection occasionally to the battery and they have to re-add it into their app. I'm sure that's something that can be fixed down the line with app updates and stuff. So hopefully Renogy does fix that soon enough. But another difference between this and the 100 amp hour batteries that I have are there are no ports on top. So on the other batteries, they had the up port and the link port for putting your batteries into shelf mode when they're being stored and then bringing them into active mode. Renogy doesn't obviously have that for this battery. It automatically does it with the BMS inside, and it also auto balances, so you don't have to link your batteries with the data cable. They will automatically balance regardless, which is honestly a really nice feature. It's just one less connection you have to make. The battery does come with an IP65 rating against water, so that gives me a little peace of mind. I have all my water and plumbing in the back of that, and I'm sure a lot of people have a fairly similar setup. If you have a big leak in your plumbing system by accident, your battery might get splashed on or get a little wet. So that's just kind of nice to know, and moisture can build up sometimes. Let's go ahead and get this installed.
All I gotta do now is turn it on. It needs at least 1 amp to switch from shelf mode into active mode. So hopefully the sun is setting, but at least I'll get 1 amp of solar power. That'll turn this on, and then I'll go ahead and show you guys how to connect it to the app and see how it works.
Moment of truth. Obviously I got a 2-aught cable here connecting the positive and the negative. Basically just took my old battery out and slid this one in, fit pretty nice. Gonna go ahead and turn the main switch on there. And looks like the charger is on. And then I can go ahead and turn the solar panels on there. There it goes. So yellow obviously means that it's not fully charged, and the red light next to the solar means that it is charging the battery. I do actually like these rubber covers. They're a nice little feature there. I also like that both connections are on one side. That makes it easier to hook up for me. It depends on your install and how your layout is, obviously, but on my last battery, there was a connection on this end and a connection on this end. That's why my negative wire is wrapped around and so long there, because it used to be connected over here. So let's download the app. Pull out my handy dandy telephone here. Into the DC app we go, and add your first device. Searching for device. Not that. All right, so it brought up, oh, there we go. Okay. So it brought up both of my devices. Request failed. I see why people don't like the app already. Haven't even been able to connect my devices. That's cool. Got it working. It says 34.6 amp hours, which is super accurate. Two decimal places. Impressive energy. Okay, so I got both my 50 amp DC to DC charger with MPPT, and then I got my battery connected here. So this is awesome. Let's see what we can do here. Go into the battery. 37.9% maximum capacity, 200 amp hours. Remaining time 30.44. Present current minus 2.5 amps, which makes sense because I have the inverter on and we're not getting any solar really. It tells me the temperature, firmware version, cell status. Yeah, that's awesome. And then we can also go into the charger, and barely any amps are coming in, so that is not all that interesting. It also tells me my starter battery volts, which is nice. And yeah, I might definitely start using this app, obviously, because I can see both devices on it. Okay, so far, I think it works pretty well. Besides that rough start, I will definitely keep you guys posted down the line, and I'm sure if there's issues that Renogy is going to probably hopefully resolve them with app updates. That is my review of the Renogy 200 amp hour Bluetooth battery. It's awesome. I love it. I wish it had the heating function because I kind of need that in a battery, but the Bluetooth function is nice. It is a perfect addition. And the price point, you just can't beat it. Like $1,000 for a 200 amp hour battery with Bluetooth is insane, like not to jump on that. So, and it is on sale. So if you guys wanna go ahead and purchase this battery, be sure to use the code MADETOTRAVEL when you check out, and you'll get an additional discount on your purchase. Also, check out my simple solar guide. It is perfect for amateurs. I explained it at the beginning of this video, so I won't go into it again. If you guys have any questions regarding the battery or solar system, be sure to ask below and I will get back to you as soon as I can. Thank you guys so much for watching. Like this video if you liked it, subscribe to the channel, and I will see you in the next one. Quick little side note, super stoked that it is summertime now and I don't need my heated battery anymore. So installing this 200 amp hour non-heated battery won't be a problem for the next few months, hopefully. Very excited about this. Very excited.